Hello students, welcome to the SRBPS virtual classroom program. I am your biology educator Prerna Rathi. So here I am yet again with another unit and another chapter. Today we will be starting with chapter 5, Principles of Inheritance and Variation. This is basically a genetics chapter where we would be learning about different phenomena of genetics. All living organisms show reproduction and it results in formation of offspring of the same kind. That's how we define reproduction. Remember, we had done in the previous unit. The resulting offspring mostly often do not resemble the parent. They are a mixture of both the parents actually. So let us now discuss what are we going to learn from this chapter. Firstly, what do we understand from the term genetics? Genetics, children, is the branch of biology that deals with the study of heredity and variation. To understand this concept, we must know what is heredity. Heredity is nothing but inheritance of characters from parents to offspring. So it is what DNA, what genes we get from our parents. Now, when we get some DNA or genes from our parents, we do not get it as it is. We do not inherit it as it is. But there are certain differences in those characters. Those differences are known as variations. There are two types of variations, children: hereditary variations and environmental variations. Hereditary variations constitute जो recombination से, meiosis से, gametes के fusion से जो genetically produced होती हैं and which are inheritable and shall be inherited in the next generation. Whereas environmental variations कौन सी होती है, which are acquired during the lifetime, and these environmental variations are non-inheritable. Let us now discuss about a very important man in the genetics field, which is father of genetics, Gregor John Mendel. He was born in the year 1822 and died in 1884. He was an Austrian monk. He performed lots of hybridization experiment in the backyard of his kitchen garden actually, where he used Picum sativum, that is pea plant, garden pea plant, and he found lots of characters, lots of phenomena that was occurring in the pea plant. Mendel was born to a family of poor peasant in Moravia, Austria. He says he was suspended, he actually himself gave up his education due to the poverty of his family. And in the year 1843, he became a monk in a church. In the year 1847, he became the head of the monastery in Austria. In the year 1851, he went to the University of Vienna and started studying natural history and mathematics. He was actually a mathematician. So basically, when he researched about the pea plant also, all the data was mathematically derived. He used various statistical ratios and mathematical ratios in order to come to conclusion. There were other people who, followed his work and produced the similar results, like Hugo de Vries from Holland, Franz Koretz in Germany, and Erich Schirmack in Austria. But we consider Mendel as the father of classical genetics, though you would be amazed to hear that his work was actually acknowledged after his death. The time when he was alive, nobody called him father of genetics, but after, when he died, people realized that the work that he has done is actually very valuable. Now, before getting into genetics, we are going to learn about some terminologies which we would be using very often in genetics. We must be familiar with all these terms before we start the basics of genetics. The first term is a factor or gene. See, the word factor was used by Mendel, obviously, because he was a mathematician. For him, gene was nowhere in the picture. So he used the term factor. What is a factor or a gene? It is the functional unit responsible for expression of a character. So basically, DNA ki ek functional unit ko hum kya kehte hain? We call it a gene. Understood? Where is the gene present? Gene is present on a locus. Gene ek chromosome pe ek jagah par present hota hai. That address is known as locus. This is the locus of a gene. Then allele. What are allele? Alleles are two different forms of contrasting characters. For example, if I consider the gene for height, then this can be capital T, because the other one is different, then it can be small t. So these are different alleles. They can be identical, you know, they can be identical alleles, capital T ho sakte hain, ya small t ho sakte hain, ya capital T small t ho sakte hain. And these two chromosomes are known as homologous chromosome. What are homologous chromosomes? Suppose out of total 46 chromosome, ye kaise hote hain? 23 ye aur 23 ye. To jo yahan pe chromosome 1 hai, us pe सपोज दिस इज़ द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ क्रोमोजोम 1, यहाँ पर एक पर्टिकुलर एलील प्रेजेंट है एक जीन का, और क्रोमोजोम 1 जो इसका क्रोमोजोम 1 है उस पर दूसरा प्रेजेंट होगा, ठीक है, इन दी अदर सेट. दीज टू क्रोमोजोम्स स्टूडेंट्स आर नोन एज होमोलोगस क्रोमोजोम्स. इन्हें क्या कहते हैं हम? होमोलोगस क्रोमोजोम्स कहते हैं. ओके, सो लेट अस फर्दर सी द अदर टर्म्स. नेक्स्ट टर्म इज फीनोटाइप. फीनोटाइप क्या होता है? फिजिकल एक्सप्रेशन. वो जीन अपने आप को किस फॉर्म में एक्सप्रेस करता है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अगर मेरे अंदर ब्लू आइज के लिए जीन प्रेजेंट है तो माई आइज विल अपियर ब्लू. हाउ डिड आई कम टू नो दैट दैट जीन इज प्रेजेंट? बिकॉज माई आइज हैव टर्न ब्लू. सो द फिजिकल अपियरेंस, द एक्सटर्नल अपियरेंस ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म इज ड्यू टू द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ द जीन, एंड दैट इज नोन एज द फीनोटाइप. वॉट डू मीन बाई जीनोटाइप? जीनोटाइप क्या है कि वो अंदर से उसका जेनेटिक कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन क्या है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अगर हम कंसिडर करें, इफ वी कंसिडर क्रॉस, आई एम गोइंग टू जस्ट शो यू हाउ इट इज डन. सपोज आपका जो हाइब्रिड बन के आया है बेटा, दैट इज कैपिटल टी स्मॉल टी. अगर आप इसको कैपिटल टी के साथ क्रॉस करा रहे हैं, और कैपिटल टी स्मॉल टी हाइब्रिड को ही स्मॉल टी के साथ क्रॉस करा रहे हैं, बोथ ऑफ दीज आर बैक क्रॉसेज. दिस वॉज वन ऑफ द पेरेंट एंड दिस वॉज वन ऑफ द पेरेंट. बोथ ऑफ दीज आर कॉल्ड बैक क्रॉस. बट This is specifically called test cross. Back cross का एक सब टाइप है. वो वाला back cross जो सिर्फ recessive parent के साथ होता है, that is known as a test. Alleles की inheritance होती है, यानी अगर हम ऐसे, if you imagine like this, capital T, small t है, अगर इसके gametes बनेंगे तो एक gamete में capital T जाएगा, एक में small t. ऐसा नहीं हो सकता कि ये दोनों एक में आ जाए और एक खाली चला जाए. हमेशा if there are capital R and capital R, then one R will go to one gamete and one R will go to one gamete. So gametes will always get half the. देखो इसमें कब करते हैं. सपोज मुझे एक प्लांट दिया गया है, आई एम गोइंग टू डिवाइड इट इनटू टू हाफ. मुझे एक प्लांट दिया गया है, मुझे बोला कि भाई आपको जो प्लांट दिया है, मैंने टॉल दिया है, इसका जीनोटाइप पता करो. ये कैपिटल टी वाला टॉल है, ये कैपिटल टी स्मॉल टी वाला टॉल है. अब देखने से तो नहीं पता चलेगा, तो मैं क्या करूँगी, दोनों ले लूँगी, कैपिटल टी को क्रॉस करूँगी स्मॉल टी के साथ. इसमें जब प्रोडक्ट बनेगा तो सारे के सारे कैपिटल टी स्मॉल टी बनेंगे, यानी सारे टॉल बनेंगे. रेशो आएगी 4:0, एक भी ड्वार्फ नहीं बनेगा. लेकिन अगर मैंने कैपिटल टी स्मॉल टी को क्रॉस किया स्मॉल टी के साथ, देन हियर आई विल गेट बोथ कैपिटल टी स्मॉल टी एज वेल एज स्मॉल टी प्रोडक्ट में, ये भी और ये भी 2:2 की रेशो में आएंगे. तो अगर मेरा ये वाला रिजल्ट आता है तो मुझे अपने आप पता लग जाएगा कि मुझे जो सैंपल दिया गया था, भले ही वो देखने में टॉल हो, बट इट इज़ हाइब्रिड टॉल. और अगर मेरा एक भी ड्वार्फ नहीं आया तो मुझे क्या पता लग जाएगा? दैट सैंपल दैट आई हैव बीन गिवन इज प्योर टॉल और डोमिनेंट टॉल. क्लियर एवरीवन? आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस. कैन यू नो सो व्हाट